For listing, lack of family support, as one of the many reasons that I wasn't open to having a third baby. My husband and I had our son knowing that we wouldn't receive much or any family assistance. My father-in-law is ill, so that takes up my mother-in-law's energy, and his siblings are child-free and not really interested in kids. My family lives far away and I never expected or received any help with babysitting, except on the rare occasions that my parents come out to visit and give us a date night. Yes, it would be amazing if my husband's family was more involved, but I've never thought anyone owed us any babysitting, and we made the choice to have kids with our eyes wide open. My husband's sister has offered to take our son a couple of times to give us a break, but ultimately flaked each time. At this point, I'm not really sure that I'd be comfortable leaving my son with her anyway, so it's not something I've pursued. I'm currently pregnant with our second son, and we told the in-laws we were having another boy during a family gathering. Everyone congratulated us, but kept asking if we were disappointed that we weren't having a girl. I repeatedly said no. I loved my son and was happy to have another boy, but they wouldn't drop the subject, and his sister kept hounding me about when we would be trying for the third so we could give the family a girl. I told her there wouldn't be a third since we were planning to stop at two kids, but she kept pursuing the topic with, three is better than two, and you don't know what you'd be missing out on not having a daughter. I found this annoying because 1, my sister-in-law has no kids and is child-free by choice, and 2, nobody in the family pays much attention to the child we already have, so I'm not sure why they are so concerned about it either way. Sister-in-law kept hounding me, and I told her that it would be difficult for us to afford a third kid with daycare costs, limited family assistance, a small home, two working parents, etc. I didn't emphasize the family piece, but it was one of several reasons that I rattled off to explain our decision. She eventually dropped it, but texted me later that night to say that she felt targeted since I knew that she wanted to babysit all those times, but something always came up. I said that was fine, my decision about the size of our family had nothing to do with her, and I never expected her to babysit, so I wasn't upset about it. Apparently, that response upset her even more because now she's telling my mother-in-law and husband that I don't think she's a good aunt, and that's not a good reason to deprive the family of a girl. My husband says not to worry about it and that's just how she is, but I probably shouldn't have mentioned family assistance if I didn't want to fight about it.